Good afternoon, my dear students. In today's class, we will continue with the next chapter, that is the DC motors. In today's class, we are going to study about the topics related to the DC motor are principle of operation, followed by this construction of this DC motor, and third one is EMF equation. And finally followed by this, we will study about the problems. So these are the topics that we are going to study in today's class regarding the DC motor. Now, as you know, that the DC motor is very widely used in many applications in electronics, electrical parts, and therefore we need to study about what is the construction, what is the principle of operation, and what is the equation that is used for making calculations regarding the EMF induced or back EMF generated by the DC motor. Now first let us look at the principle of operation of the DC motor. Now the principle of operation of DC motor basically involves, right, a permanent magnet consisting of north and south poles here, and between these north and south poles a coil is placed, and this coil is connected to commutator, which is connected to a DC supply, and when the DC supply is given to this, the current flows through the coil, and since current flow through the coil which is placed in magnetic field will get experienced by a force, and that force will make this coil to rotate, and this rotation will result in motion. And therefore, this is basically the idea behind this. You can just look at the diagram regarding the principle of operation of DC motor. So, what is there inside this motor so that we can understand how this motor is able to produce rotations, right? Now, after having seen this particular diagram, now as you see in the figure, right, there are two figures here, figure A and figure B. In figure A, there is a coil ABCD which is placed between the north and south poles of a magnet, right, and then this coil is connected to commutator ends S1 and S2 through the brushes B1 and B2, and these two brushes are insulated from each other, and they help in making connection of this coil with the DC supply connected externally, and this DC supply is connected here. This is the DC source battery, and this is the key which is basically used as an on-off switch, and this is the resistance used for basically for limiting the current to the motor. Now in the first figure, as you see here, when the battery is positive is connected to the side B1 and negative is connected through the resistor to the B2. Now what is going to happen here in this one is the current always flows through the positive of the battery. So the current that comes from here through this positive end of this one passes through this coil, and here the current is entering at point A. And from A, it is going towards B, and from B, it is coming to C, from C, it is coming to D, and from D, it is coming to B2, and from B2 through S2, it is connected back to the battery. This is the direction of current. Now, this current flow when it flows here in this side, what happens here basically? Right? The operation is very clear. When the current flows through this coil from A to B, B to C, C to D in this direction, and since this current flow is perpendicular to the magnetic field, so where is the magnetic field? Magnetic field will be always originating from the north pole and terminating with the south pole, right? So this magnetic field lines will be available here from the north pole to south pole, and this is like this, and the current is perpendicular to this, and therefore these two perpendicular to each other will cause a force to be set up which is perpendicular in the direction of these two, right, which is given by Fleming's left hand rule. So that I am going to explain it later about the left hand rule. Now due to this force, the side AB will be lifted up and side CD will be lifted down. Why this lifting up and lifting down takes place is in coil, right, from A to B when current flows, and because of the magnetic field from north to south, the force experienced will be perpendicular to the direction, therefore it will be lifted up. And the current is flowing from A to B. Whereas in case of C to D, it is flowing in the reverse direction. Right? It is flowing from C to D in the opposite direction compared to the A to B. So because of this, what happens is the force experienced by this will be in the downward direction. So due to this, what happens is the rotation of motion will be there. Similarly, in figure B again, what is the difference that we have seen? Right? Both figures are same, except that when this coil is rotated by half revolution, then what happens? This AB will be coming to the position CD and CD will be going back to the position AB. That you can see here. Now it is CD is has come on the north pole side and AB is available on the south pole side. And second difference that you can see here in this one is S1, S2 are remaining as this, B1, B2 are remaining as this. So there is no difference here in this one, right? So now only thing is the coil has been rotated from north pole towards the south pole by making half revolution, and after this the coil current is going to have some change. What is the change here? You can see here that if the positive of the battery is connected through the switch or through the key, through this S1 connection to the D, from D to C the current is flowing in the direction from D to C. Please remember this, this is very important. And again, this current which is going from B to C is going to C to B. From B to A it is coming back. So earlier it was going from A to B, now it is from B to A. So because of this again, the rotation or the force that is experienced will remain same, and therefore the rotation will continue in the same direction. This is what is happening here in this one. So to understand more about this, I will just show some more diagrams which will be indicating clearly how this force is acting on this in the next slides. Now first let me make use of the two diagrams which I have shown you earlier to explain about how this motor is, what is the principle in AC motor. Figure 20.1, that is the first figure which I showed earlier, shows a coil ABCD wound on an armature, the ends of which are connected to the two halves of a ring properly insulated from each other, forming the split ring or the commutator. So this commutator is represented in the figure by S1, S2, and it is insulated from each other and both are connected to the two ends of the coil ABCD. This is regarding how this coil is placed and how this coil is connected to the commutator. Then carbon brushes B1, B2 are used for pressing against the commutator by means of springs. So by using springs, the coils are pressed against this commutator by using the two carbon brushes B1 and B2 as shown in the figure that you have seen already. The armature is placed between the two poles north and south of a strong electromagnet. It is not permanent magnet here, it is electromagnet. That means when current passes through this, the material becomes get magnetized. So the armature is placed between the two poles north and south of a strong electromagnet over which a field winding is placed. Right? So over which, that means over this electromagnet, a field winding is placed. When current passes through the field winding, the magnet, the what you call electromagnet will get magnetized. Next, when the DC supply is switched on, so as we have seen, we have connected a DC battery, right, through a key to the ABCD coil. When the DC supply is switched on, the direction of current flowing through the coil ABCD is shown in the figure 20.1. Right? You can just go back to this figure to see what is the direction of this. This is the figure he is referring here, and that is the battery DC source is connected through the key or through the switch to brush or to the point S1 of the commutator. From here it is connected to the ABCD coil. And how the current is flowing from the pulse of the battery through S1, through A, B, C, D, it is coming back to the S2. From S2, it is going back to the negative of the battery. This is the direction of the current. Right? When the DC supply is switched on, the direction of current flowing in the coil ABCD shown in the figure that you have seen. As a result, a force will act on each arm of the coil. This is because of the Fleming's left hand rule. So when a moving coil, or even a coil, when current passes through a conductor which is placed in a magnetic field, a force is exerted on the coil and that force will make them to rotate. So as a result, a force will act on each arm of the coil, the direction of which is given by Fleming's left hand. Right? So please make a note of this rectangle, I am going to give the description about this, what is this rectangle is basically, right? So this particular part, I will show by means of a diagram how this force, current and magnetic field are interrelated. The system thus forms a couple. So what is couple here? Couple is nothing but there are two coils. It is on side, on the side AB, current is flowing from A to B, therefore the force will be in the upward direction. On the side CD, the current is flowing in the opposite direction, therefore the force will be in the downward direction. So these two, one force is in the upward direction, the other force is in the downward direction. So these two forces will make it to rotate like this, right? You are able to follow this. This is very important, right? They will be rotating in this direction, this way. The system thus forms a couple acting on the armature, which sets it into rotation. So this will make the motor to rotate. The couple that is acting on the coil, which is making the left hand side coil to have a force acting in the upward direction, on the right hand side the coil's force, the force acting on the coil is in the downward direction, and therefore these two forces which are acting opposite to each other is basically called as a couple. So this couple which is acting on this one will rotate the motor in the direction, that is in the clockwise direction, till the coil completes half revolution. So how long it will do? So this will be completing a one half revolution. That means if this is the coil, the position like this, if the forces are like this, this will be working half revolution like this, completely like this. So once it comes to this one, now this side coil AB has come this side and CD has come to the other side. So this will be referring to the figure 2 that you can see here in the diagram. Now what is Fleming's left hand rule? So which I have referred here in the previous case. So the Fleming's left hand rule basically says that the left hand is held with the thumb, index finger and middle finger mutually at right angles. So here I would like to show by means of this. Left hand I have taken. So I am showing these three fingers, the thumb and index finger and middle finger. So these three fingers are taken and they are kept mutually perpendicular to each other. Please remember this. This is very important. So keep it like this. If the first finger points in the direction of magnetic field, this is the first finger, right? This is representing the direction of magnetic field. And the second finger in the direction of the current, the second finger is this, middle finger basically, right? This finger is representing the direction of current. If current is flowing in this direction, if the magnetic field is in this direction, then a force will be exerted on the direction of the thumb. Right, then the thumb will be pointing in the direction of the force on the conductor. So if the conductor is placed in such a way that it is subjected to the magnetic field and a current I is flowing, if the direction of current is represented by this middle finger and if the direction of magnetic field is represented by this first finger or fourth finger we call it as, then a force is exerted on this conductor and this force will be perpendicular to these two, that is the thumb will be representing the direction of the force. This is basically the Fleming's left hand rule that gives us the direction of force acting on a conductor which is placed in a magnetic field through which a current I is flowing. Clear about this? Please remember this. This rule is very important to be used here, especially for understanding how this motor rotation basically takes place. If the first finger points in the direction of the magnetic field and the second finger the direction of the current in the wire, then thumb will be pointing in the direction of the force in the conductor. So this is the basis for the how this rotation takes place in a. So Fleming's left hand rule is an important rule that is to be remembered here to understand this. The same thing has been shown diagrammatically by means of the diagram in the slide. You can just look at this. And the forefinger is representing the field. The field here is magnetic field, and the middle finger is representing the direction of current. Right, and the motion is in the direction of thumb. So thumb is representing the direction of this. For example, if this is like this, so here the direction of current is like this. Now in case if I change it like this, that means what happened? My direction of current is reversed. So when the direction of current is reversed, what happens? Then the force will be acting in the downward direction. So therefore whenever current through the conductor which is placed in a magnetic field is reversed, the force acting will be in the direction opposite to the previous one. So this particular rule is to be used here for finding the direction of rotation of the motor. I think it is clear about this. This left hand rule is an important rule that is to be remembered. Now I'll continue with the same principle of operation, because in between we got that left hand's rule. So Fleming's left hand rule, which is used basically for understanding how this rotation of conductor takes place, which is placed in the magnetic field carrying a current I. Now, as soon as half rotation of the coil is completed, so as I showed earlier, the figure A is representing the direction of current when motor is when the coil is connected to the DC supply through the commutators S1 and S2. So in that case, the direction of current was from A to B, and then B to C, and then C to D, and back to the battery. But here, as soon as this rotation is completed, how much rotation it is? It's half rotation. So after this half revolution or half rotation of the coil is completed, segment S1 of the commutator comes in contact with the brush B2 and segment S2 with brush B1. So therefore, there will be some interchange in the brush contacts with the commutator terminals. So commutator terminals and brush contacts will be having some change, and that change is going to make, right, in such a way that the side CD will be coming to the side AB in the first figure, and side AB will be coming to the side CD of the first figure. That means the coil ABCD will be changed from DCBA, right? DCBA, right? I think let's go back to this diagram and then see how this direction is shown. See, DCBA is the direction. Here also you can see here B1, S1, B2, S2 are connected here as it is in this figure. But practically this will be S1 will be connected to B2 and S2 will be connected to B1, so that the direction of coil will be reversed. So in the second figure B, as you see here, the current is flowing now from D to C and C to B and B to A, and therefore the forces which are existing will be again, so D to C is carrying the current, therefore the force will be in the upward direction. So the motor, which was having the what you call couple like this, is rotated like this too by half, right? It is like this. Now it has come to this position. Now what happened? This portion has come to this side, and therefore the current is flowing in the from the direction from D to C, and therefore this will continue to rotate in this direction. Therefore it will make a complete 360 degrees revolution. So this results in reversing the direction of current in the coil as shown in figure 20.1. So I have shown the diagram already. So in this case, the direction of current is changed in the coil ABCD. Now it is flowing from D, C, and C to B, and B to A it is coming back, and therefore the forces which are acting on the DC will be in the upward direction, the force acting on the BA will be in the downward direction, and therefore the rotation which has come from this side will continue to rotate, and therefore it will move in a clockwise direction. The direction of rotation of the commutator remains unchanged and it keeps on rotating in one direction, right? So therefore the coil will keep on moving in the same direction as it is, because the force acting on this one is keeping the coil to rotate in the clockwise direction continuously, and therefore it makes a complete revolution after the reversal of the current through the coil. So earlier it was from A, B, C, D, and then now it is from D, C, B, A. So this change in the direction of current will keep the motor to continue the same direction. Clear about this? So this is an important principle involved here in case of DC. After having understood the principle of operation, let us go to study about this in the form of an animation. So I am showing an animation here indicating how the motor rotates. The motor rotation here, as you can see, the battery is connected here, right? This is the battery which is connected here with plus minus, and the current flows through this, through the brushes. It is connected to the coil, and this is basically the commutator which is rotating, and therefore now the coil which was placed here is rotating inside this, right? And this animation will help you to understand about this, how this rotation takes place in a DC motor. This rotation is in the same direction, you can see here, it is in the clockwise direction. Why it is in the clockwise direction? Because every time it makes half revolution, the direction of current through the coil is going to change, which makes it to continue in the same direction, and this makes it to be more meaningful for us to understand about how the current flowing through the coil is moving only in one direction in case of DC motor. Clear about this animation? So after having seen this particular animation, you can just see practically how these internal parts will be rotating here by the next animation diagram. You can see here in the second animation how this DC motor is rotating. So what are the various parts involved in this particular thing? So as you see here, rotor coils, stator magnets, these are the two magnets which are available here, which are shown by this. This is the one coil, one magnet. This is the other magnet, that is north and south pole of a magnet. And inside this there is a rotor, right? Rotor, and wound with coils on this, and the commutator is placed here in this one. And these are the brushes available here, and this is the shaft connected to this rotor. Now the rotation is, you can see here, it is going, it is rotating in the same direction, that is in the clockwise direction. So this clockwise direction rotation of the motor is an important thing, because in case of DC motor, when the battery is connected with one end positive, the other end negative, then the rotation will be in one direction. So in case if you reverse the battery, what happens? So in case of DC motor, if the battery terminals are reversed, then in that case what happens? There will be change. What is the change in this direction of rotation? There will be change in the direction of rotation, right? Because when the current flowing through the coil is reversed, when the battery connect terminals are reversed, the direction of current flowing through the coil also will reverse, and therefore the direction of motion will be opposite to the one which is shown here. That means in the anti-clockwise direction. Right, so these two animations which I am showing here will help you to understand about how this basically DC motor rotates and what is the reason for rotation. So this is basically because of electric and magnetic field interaction. So the electric and magnetic field interactions which is making the force to get developed on the coil, and this force which results in developing a couple of the coil is making it rotate in a particular direction depending on the direction of depending on the polarity of the DC supply connected to the motor. Now we have seen the principle of operation, right? So with all the diagrams that we have got, which basically indicate the basic idea behind how the DC motor rotates. What is the basic idea? The idea is, it is basically the magnetic field and electric field interaction which results in developing a force, and that force which is developed on the coil will rotate it, because of which the rotation takes place in the DC motor. Now this DC motor operation, I would like to enhance it more by means of the diagrams which I am going to show in the slides, in the form of slides. You just look at these slides. These slides will be basically representing the way in which the current is flowing, the way in which the force is just set up, and the way in which the direction of the motor will be. You can see here, this is south pole, north pole, right? So a coil is placed inside this through the brushes and commutator. When electric current passes through a coil in a magnetic field, the magnetic force produces a torque which turns the DC motor. This is the basic simple thing which you can understand, or which you can remember for this. So when electric current passes through a coil in a magnetic field, the magnetic force produces a torque in the motor which turns the motor in a particular direction depending on the direction. Now here, the electric current supplied externally through a commutator. So we are applying this electric current. How it is coming from? It is coming from the DC battery or DC source connected to the motor. So this current is going, that means the positive battery is connected to this, and therefore current is going from here. Through this, it is going into this coil and moving into this and coming back to this in this direction. So this direction here, which is flowing here in this direction, is producing a force in the upward direction. And here, this is producing a force in the downward direction. Because why this is downward direction? Because the current is flowing here in this direction, and here current is flowing in the opposite direction. Because of this, the two forces are opposite to each other, which results in rotation of this coil. So the rotation of the coil is from there in this direction. So the direction of rotation also is shown here. Now another important thing that you can understand here is, the magnetic field B is having its origin from north and ending at south. So from north to south poles through the complete magnet, they will be occupying these lines there, because the magnetic flux lines are basically the continuous lines and current is flowing in this direction. So magnetic field is in this direction and current is in this direction, so perpendicular to this, this will be force. Therefore the force F and magnetic field B and current I, all the three will be perpendicular to each other. They are called as mutually perpendicular to each other. Now in the same diagram, I would like to show how this direction of current is basically decided and how it is enabling this coil to rotate in a particular direction. So electric current is supplied by the external source, that is DC battery, through a commutator connected through the brushes. The commutator reverses, this is very important. So here the current I1 is flowing, the current I, which is indicated by this red one, is flowing here in this direction when this point is connected to the positive with respect to this point. So during this time, what happens is this side of the coil will be moving up and this side of the coil will be moving down, and therefore after some time what happens, this rotation will be completing half cycle and then will be coming back to the, that means this end will come to the north side and this end will go to the south side. The commutator reverses the current in current each half revolution to keep the torque turning the coil in the same direction. So after half revolution of this one, what happens is the direction of current flowing through the coil will be changing, and accordingly the torque developed inside the coil will make the coil to rotate in the same direction. So this is an important aspect that is to be remembered. It is the direction of current that matters here for the torque to develop in the to cause the motion to be in the same direction. Now, so once you have seen how the current is